can only translate to language if you understand it. And basic science is our way to understand the language of life. I'm originally from Lebanon, and I would have stayed in Lebanon, but the Civil War interrupted that. My original landing was in Texas on July 4th, 1976. And the thought was I'll be here for the summer. And when school starts back in October, I'll be back home. By October, everything became impossible to enter Lebanon. I started applying to medical school. And basically the answer I got, you're a transfer student and you're 2 months late. School started in August, so we can't take you. And finally, I went to Meharry Medical College, told them my story, and they looked at my grades and they said, you can start tomorrow. So I ended up in Meharry Medical College and I finished my medical education there. Then came back to Houston for residency.
I'm really curious to see if those have degeneration.
Yeah. Getting trained in child neurology, I realized what a devastating specialty that is. We would tell parents, we think your child has a genetic disease, that this might happen again in your family, but we don't know the cause and we can't do anything about it. When I was studying Rett syndrome, people told me, don't work on Rett syndrome. It's such a rare disease. Work on autism. It's much more common. And encountering girls with Rett syndrome, that really inspired me to go into science. In 1999, about 3 years after receiving the Howard Hughes funds, our lab identified the gene of Rett syndrome. The Rett gene is a Goldilocks gene. If you have too little of it, you get Rett syndrome. If you have too much of it, you get another neurological disorder called the MECP2 duplication. From there, we really dug deep to understand how can mutations in this one gene produce a neurological disease that affects every part of the brain. It turns out, by discovering the gene of Rett syndrome, we were able to help the broader field of autism.
That's beautiful.
My lab works in two areas, childhood neurodevelopmental disorders, particularly Rett syndrome and autism, and adult neurodegenerative disorders, a balance disorder and Alzheimer disease. There's always something new we are learning. I have very simple principles in the lab. Let's do the best we can do. Let's collaborate, be generous, and let's do science with an impact. My inspiration to go to the lab were patients. The first one that really grabbed my heart and attention was my first patient with Rett syndrome, who is now in her 40s. Whenever she sees me, she goes, it's like, it's you. I feel she really remembers. She will always be in my heart. After years of research, and happy to say that clinical trials for the MECP2 duplication disorder will start in the third quarter of 2024. My greatest accomplishment in science is training graduate students and fellows and physician scientists who will now continue this mission and impact many lives moving forward.